Hi everyone, so this video is part of a series of tutorials about e-textiles and wearable electronics, which is all available on my website in the description down below. For this video, I'm going over how to design your own circuits in order to make your own light up accessories. And I've also got two demonstration samples to show today, one of which is this really cool cyber eye monster bracer, along with a necklace, which can also just as well be turned into a bracelet. So if all of that interests you, then please keep watching. These are two parallel circuits I have designed here, which will be used for this tutorial. Both of these circuits have been designed around the power source, which for these are the coin battery holder. This one in particular is a LilyPad one, but there are other brands like Keychronic, Dueno Tech, amongst others. I'll leave a few links in the description below. With this holder in particular, if you look closely, there are two sets of marked pins, so two positive and two negative. This is great because you can actually make two different circuits and connect them to the same power source, so one over here and then another one over here, which is basically this first circuit here. Just to illustrate, we've got the red pin for positive and black for negative. So following from the positive pins, we've got positive to positive, and these here are LEDs, so there's going to be two LEDs on each side. And then after the positive's done, we'll do the negative. So it's coming around here, so negative to negative, and then linking back to the power holder. And then it's the same on this side, so the circuit will be complete when we link the negatives back to here. So now we have two complete circuits. If I cover this, this here is a complete circuit, as well as this side. Which means that once you switch the power source on, it will turn on both circuits, and it will remain on so long as it is switched on here. And because this is a bracelet design, there's just two snaps here which will close the bracelet, and because they're not connected to the circuit at all, it won't have any issue with it. So with this design done, we'll look at this one here. This circuit is building on from the first concept, but we're actually turning it into one big circuit instead of two little circuits. You can add any conductive material to a circuit and it will have its own unique function. So in this case, I am using the snap domes, which now have two functions. One is the closure of the wrist, but now it's actually being used as a kind of button to complete the circuit. So the simple concept of a button is that they interrupt a circuit until it is connected or pushed down, and this will actually allow the current to flow through and complete the circuit. So drawing out the positive, we've got this here leading from the battery pack to the first dome, and it's going to come all the way around when we close it on our wrist to this snap here, and we'll continue through to positive, positive, and positive. And then it's the same case with the negative, so from there to the dome, and then it'll come around when it's closed and link to this one. So from there to negative to negative. So presently, as the bracelet is flat, it will not light up because it's an incomplete circuit. If you wanted to complete it, you would just simply connect the lines back to here, which would make all this a complete circuit, but that's not the point of this project. But once it's around our wrist and the circuit is closed, so we'll come around here and connect, and the same here. So once it's looped around our wrist and is closed, this is now a complete circuit and it will work. So I really like this because the domes now are no longer just practical for wearing it, but it actually has a function in the circuit. So all of this leads into my two demonstrations for this video. The designs you will see are a little bit abstract, as I wanted to show how you can expand on these basic fundamentals. It really doesn't have to be a basic project or even a bracelet, it's just giving a good starting point. So my first design is based on this concept of the first bracelet, except we're only focusing on one single side of it. So this is my idea, and this is what I turned it into, which is going to be a bracer that's going to go across the arm. And the reason why these lines are all squiggly instead of straight across is because the thread needs to be curved around to follow and join with all the LEDs. Because one big important thing about conductive thread is that the lines have to be separate from everything else. You cannot have the positive and negative crossing over each other, otherwise this will make the circuit not work at all. So if I draw this in, so positive, positive, to positive, then negative, to negative, to negative, to negative. So these lines need to have enough space between them to curve around, and they cannot cross over at all. And this is the finished bracer. I'm about to show you how it was made in a moment, but the little power source there, so that's hidden right under here, and when you switch it on, the lights will turn on. And the back here is closed with a hook and loop fastener. And you can see on the back the lines of the conductor thread, and on top it is just a separate cover, just for looks. I'll show you the second project, and then let's get right into how it was made. So the second project is actually exactly the same as this one. I turned it into pretty much what is a long bracelet, so it can be worn around my neck as a choker. So if I switch it on here, it will not switch on, the lights won't turn on because the circuit is incomplete. But once I snap this closed, the lights will turn on. And then once I unsnap it, the lights will no longer turn on. And you can see at the back here, here is all of my conductor stitching. So with all that out of the way, let's see how it was made. Now to start with, I want to show you a technique that I'm figuring out, and that is how to mold LEDs into fun shapes. I have these silicone molds that are commonly used for resin art. You can use resin for these, but to avoid the drying time and the fumes, I am opting to use hot glue instead. So what I'm doing here is just squeezing in some hot glue and then adding a standard LED in with the leg sticking at the end. And for e-textiles, make sure the LED you are using works to the same voltage as the power source. The hot glue creates a frosted effect which helps disperse light across the entire shape, as you can see here. It just makes the LEDs look a little more interesting instead of the standard bulb shape that you expect. To make them look more like eyeballs, I'm just painting a black dot in the middle for the pupil and leaving it to dry. The pattern for the bracer is up on my website if you would like to make something similar. Here I am just cutting it out of felt, which is my base fabric. Felt is perfect because it is easy to sew, it doesn't fray, and is stable enough to keep my stitches and LEDs in place. Then I'm just cutting the cover for the bracer in this holographic pleather. This will help hide the stitches and just generally looks pretty cool. Also here, I am cutting out the eye shapes for the LEDs to shine through. Here you can see on the sides that I cut the cover slightly smaller than the main piece. This is because I am attaching hook and loop tape later to each side so it closes around my arm. Now I'm just using some black paint to create some eyeliner around the eye shapes to make them pop. The next step is prepping the LEDs. Because I'm using standard LEDs, the legs need to be bent into loops. Before doing this, I need to mark one of the legs to help me remember which is which. Here I am marking the short leg, which is the negative. Just bending the legs flat and making loops big enough for my sewing needle to pass through. Now all of that is done, here are the components I am using to make the circuit. We have a Duino Tech Power Pad coin cell holder, our three LEDs, conductive thread, normal sewing thread, and a sewing needle. Now we're just laying everything out, making sure the eyes line up with the holes on the top cover. Here I'm just drawing out my circuit plan with a fabric pen so I have a direction to follow. The little line next to the battery holder will be cut just so I can get in there and remove the battery if it needs replacing. Then it's just sewing the circuit. In this case, we are starting with the negative thread. If you are new to e-textiles, I have a beginner's guide on my website, so please have a look. In simple terms, here I am just using one thread to sew and link up all the negative pins, so looping around each pin multiple times. And after all of the negative pins are sewn and finished off, it's time to sew the positive thread. All in a simple running stitch and looping around each pin to secure them to the fabric. Once they're all sewn in, it's time to turn them on and see how it looks. Just using normal thread, I'm just sewing the leftover pins of the battery holder to the fabric to stop them from wiggling around. Now the circuit is all done, it's just a case of attaching the cover and adding details. Instead of pinning the two layers together, I'm just using some clips so it doesn't leave holes. Then I'm just sewing all around to attach both layers together using a blanket stitch. The good thing is it doesn't have to be pretty because I will be covering it up very soon. The only gap I'm leaving is where the battery holder is, just so I can get my fingers in to switch it on and off when needed. Next, I'm adding the hook and loop tape, which is also commonly known by the name Velcro. You can either use the standard sew-on tape like I have here, or a sticky version which has glue on one side so you don't need to sew it. This was all I had at home, but to be honest, either works just as fine. And now I'm just adding some finishing details with some rhinestones. Now, rhinestones work great to hide any imperfect sewing and catch the light, which is very effective on light up clothing. And we can't forget some little eyelashes, finished with some little rhinestones on top. With the first project all finished, let's jump into the second project. So this necklace uses the exact same hot glue LED technique, just molded into these cute little spikes instead. And I'm using the same electronic components as before, though just with different colored LEDs. Same as before, bend the legs around into loops so they can be sewn. The smaller the hot glue shape is, the easier this will be to do. The pattern to make this necklace was basically a really long rectangle. It was also cut in two layers, so one layer is the felt for sewing, and the other is pleather to cover and hide the stitching. Here I'm just arranging the LEDs and taping them down to the felt to keep them in place. And instead of using a pen, I'm just using some chalk to mark the circuit. And just as a reference, I've just got my diagram up above. So same as before, just getting into sewing the circuit. Except for this time, we are connecting the LEDs to the snap fasteners instead of directly to the power source. Make sure to line up your positive and negative pins in the same way, and that the conductive thread is sewn well to the snap domes and the LEDs to ensure a strong connection. Then the power source is just connected to the other snap fasteners on the other side. And just finishing the knots with some nail polish to keep them secure. And it's also a good idea to check that the necklace is working by switching it on and closing the snaps. So once they're all connected, it should turn on like this. With the circuit all complete, now I just need to add the cover. Because this pleather is slightly stretchy, I just need to cut a small cross where the LED will go and just push it over the LED. And then it all just ends up underneath the LED and just makes the entire finish look nice and tidy. And once all of that is done, I clipped the layers together and sewed around the entire necklace with a blanket stitch. This part is just adding all of the fun details. And finally, we are done. Both projects are pretty cute and super simple to make. It mostly just depends on how you would like to personalize it. I hope this was helpful to you and to, you know, jog some ideas for inspiration. But with all of that being said, thank you so much for watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I will see you later. Bye.